So you've just purchased our Component 1 controls? Great. Let's get started with licensing. If your license was purchased after our July 2020 V2 release, you likely have a license key with 19 characters like this. To activate these keys, you can utilize either the Component 1 control panel or the Grape City License Manager, which are both included when you download the controls from our website. Let's look at the Grape City License Manager utility first. The Grape City License Manager, or GCLM.exe, can be found by navigating to the following file path, which is the default installation location. When the GCLM opens, you'll notice every installed Component 1 edition will be listed. Select Activate under the edition that correlates with your license purchase. Enter the key and click Activate. If you don't see the edition related to your license key listed, then you can either install the product or use the Component 1 Control Panel's License tab to activate your license. This approach will also work to activate older 24-character serial keys. To find the Component 1 Control Panel, you can search for it in the Windows taskbar by typing Component 1 Control Panel as one word. By default, it should be found at the following file path. Once you launch the application, you'll be asked to sign into your Grape City account. If you know your credentials, feel free to sign in now, or you can select to proceed as anonymous user. Once inside, you'll want to navigate to the License tab at the top. Here, you'll be asked to fill in your name, company, and serial key information, which we can use to keep a record of your license key in the event you misplace your license information. Once the information is filled in, click Activate to activate your key. To confirm the key activated successfully and to see what edition of the controls your license key is valid for, you can click on the View Installed Keys link above the Activate button. Now that you have successfully activated your license, let's move on to licensing the controls used within your applications. For any .NET projects built using Component 1 NuGet packages, a licensing file called the GCLICX file is generated. This license file is generated when the application is built and contains the runtime license. This file must remain as an embedded resource in your final application. For WinForms and WPF.NET framework projects that reference Component 1 libraries or DLLs directly, a traditional licenses.licx file is still required. The licenses file is included as an embedded resource, and it lists each component that is used within the project. When you add controls from the toolbox, the licenses file is generated and updated automatically, but you can also create this file manually if necessary. Check our licensing documentation to find additional instructions on activating keys, generating license files, and licensing different types of applications. For more in-depth help with licensing, please contact our support team through email or phone so that we can work towards resolving your issues and getting you back up to speed as quickly as possible. To learn more about everything Component 1 has to offer, continue with the Component 1 Getting Started series.